Hi, thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to show you how to make this good egg basket, and I call it also a shallow basket. It will hold candy in here, or you can even put a big stack of post-it notes. You just might want to leave the handle off if you put the post-it notes in there. Okay, let's get started. You're going to start with a white piece of cardstock, and this is, again, 6x6. You're going to score it at 1.5 on all four sides. This Fiskars trimmer is in our Stampin' Up! Catalog, and you need to purchase the scoring blades separately. It comes with the orange blades, which is the cutting blade, and the black blade is the scoring. Okay, so we're going to fold this on the score lines, and then I've made a template. The red sticky strip is where I'm going to put my adhesive, and these are my cut lines. So, looking at the template, I'm going to cut and then turn it and do the exact same spot on this end. And then make sure when you use your adhesive that you put it where it's marked, because if you put it on the other side, it's not going to work right. Instead of using sticky strip on my sample today, I'm just going to use regular adhesive so that it will go faster. So this is the snail adhesive. Now here's the catch. If you do not want your ribbon to show, you're going to attach your ribbon here, okay? If it doesn't bother you that it shows, then you don't have to attach it at that point. You can just Well, I'll show you when we get to that point, okay? Now this part's a little tricky just because you have to bring it over. But it's not hard. You just place it right there in the middle. Try to always make sure you put it in the middle so that it will match. Hopefully I'm not covering this up. Maybe I should hold it up. See? Isn't that cute? Okay, now what I'm going to do is attach my designer paper. This is the Delicate Dots designer paper from the Celebration Catalog. In fact, the ribbon is from the Celebration Catalog as well, and that's the ribbon bundle. So this is the designer paper. And what I'm going to do is go ahead and put adhesive on all four sides, or all four pieces of the sides. Sticking to me. Okay. And then the last one. Okay. See? Here's our box. Now, I'm going to take my chick stand, and I'm going to set it right there, and I'm going to attach the silver brad. The brads I'm using are from the filigree brads. They're really bright and shiny, and because I've already used the flowers, I have these leftover brads, and I like them. The ribbon, I cut it at 9 inches, but you could use it. You can use an 8-inch piece if you'd like. Okay. Well, I can't find the little, I can't get the prong to open. Sometimes it pokes me. There we go. So there's that part. And the last step, of course, is just we're going to do the little chick there. I've gone ahead and cut my, what is this, crinkle paper. And there's a video on how to do that if you're not sure how to do that. So now all I just need to do is the chick. The blue circle that you see behind it is actually from our Circles Number 2 die, and it measures 1.5 inches. So I've gone ahead and punched that. And if you have a punch, you could use that, but we don't currently have one in our Stampin' Up! Catalog. So if you have this die, it works perfect. Okay, so I'm going to take my black stays on ink and stamp the chick. Move this out of the way. The colors I'm going to use today are Bashful Blue, Barely Banana, and Celery. And I know I use green a lot, but you know, this is an Easter project, and it really calls for these colors. Now I'm looking for my aqua painter. It's buried in here. Okay, so the first color I'm going to use is the celery, and I'm just going to color. Ooh, I got it kind of bright, didn't I? See, this would be the point where I would say, whoop, start over. But that's okay. I'll tell you what I needed here. The reason it's so dark, I actually needed a little bit more water. It'll be okay. Okay, close that up. Get my cloth here. I'm going to use the Barely Banana for his beak. And then I use the Bashful Blue for the egg. And I'm going to have to get some water started in there. There we go. Actually turned out pretty good. Okay, at this point, before I attach the glitter, I'm actually going to punch it out, okay? If you get glitter in your punches, it's just really kind of hard to get that glitter out, and then it always makes that really scratchy sound. I know some of you know what I'm talking about. So I'm going to layer this onto my, my Bashful Blue 1.5 inch circle, and I'm going to put a dimensional right on the back. I'm going to punch my scallop circle using the scallop circle punch. But before I attach it, I'm going to pierce it really fast. Okay. And now I'm going to attach or apply the glitter. So I'm just going to use the two-way glue pen and just brush a little bit of glue on here. Take my Dazzling Diamonds glitter. I'm just moving everything around. Straighten it back out. Okay, see how cute that is? And then now you could either attach this with a dimensional or some regular adhesive. I'm going to use a dimensional because that kind of holds it on. Uh-oh, the dogs are barking. So, there you have it. If you have any questions, let me know. Thanks.